Hello, everybody. It's Dr. Zaino with 15 Minute Fuel, where it's just in 15 minutes a day, one for your mind, your body, and your future. Well, when I'm waiting for everybody to get on, I'm in a different location. I'm in the gym area here, and it's kind of good for winning. You got Rocky in the background beating Drago. So the kids are at Justice, you know, the school year ended, and we don't believe in summers off. Reason being, it's not real life. Like, name one parent who takes the summers off besides a teacher, right? So we believe real life is that, you know, when you have a job or a profession or a purpose, you do it every day. So Justice has never taken a summer off, and that's how he gets ahead. You know, he's two or three levels ahead in math and stuff like that. So he started summer tutoring today, and he just keeps on going because that's just how things are. So thank you so much for getting on board. And so if you have not, go to imhero.com. You can just open up another browser or something. Go to imhero.com, sign up, subscribe for free, and you'll get my 1 month to win. It's a video course I made specifically for you guys at my cost. It's broken into weeks. It's five videos a week, weekends off, to do the exercises that go with it, because it's not just videos and text. There's actually little things and questions for you to ponder on and think and apply. And it's baby steps, so it's not overwhelming. And in 1 month, you'll be winning in every area of your life. And then you'll at least be realizing the areas that you are winning in. You know, a lot of times we could get in such a funk, and I say, so, you know, and you say, well, that person's doing great. And I'm like, well, what are you doing great in? And people are like, well, I don't know. And then you really look in their life, they're doing great in so many things. They're a great parent. You know, they're a wonderful wife or husband. So, you know, we take for granted the things we are winning in. So if the only thing it does is make you aware of the areas that you are doing amazing in, you can start focusing on that and realizing the truth of the matter. So what I'll do is for you guys, you know, I made the program. I want you to be able to enjoy it. So make sure you get on top of that. But I'll go through it with you. So for over the next month, we'll be doing 15-minute fuels Monday through Friday. Some of you guys noticed I took Saturday off. And someone's like, why did I take Saturday off? Because I had nothing to talk about on Saturday. That's it. And so some days you don't. And Sunday we'll probably do Sunday. So Monday through Friday, we'll be doing the 15-minute fuels. And I'll be going through each one that we go through. So today we're going to start with day one. And day one, when it comes to winning, and these are from reading all the books that I've read and studying people who are just, they just win, meaning that they hit their goals. Looking at the signpost in my life, whether it be when I did concert piano or bodybuilding or just anything that I achieved at, you start to see very common characteristics and signposts, as I like to call them. And you have them too. I'm just going to actually name them, what they are. So the first thing we have to do before you start winning, before we get to the principles, the number one principle to winning is going to be commitment, 100%. Commitment. Now, commitment means, the way I would like to think of it is when you make the decision, right? You got to make, I guess the first one would be making a decision. When you make the decision and you commit. Now, committing, I'm using it in the definition of, like, all in committed, you know, no exit strategy, you know, burn the bridges, break the boats type of commitment. Like you said, it's your word, spit on your hand, here's your word, I'm committed. That means you're committed to whatever the future may hold, right? Good, bad, and different, you're going to go toward it. So commitment's going to be a huge thing because that starts it off. But I think it's very important before you start a goal is to ask yourself, honestly, you know, is this something I could be 98 to 100% committed in? And the reason being is because I know if I try things, T-R-Y, try them, and just to kind of see how it goes, I'm not really too committed to it. And then I wonder why I'm not getting great results because I'm trying it. And when I'm trying it and not getting great results, and I say, this doesn't work for me, and I quit, right? I just stop doing it because I'm trying. I'm not committed. But when I'm committed, then I don't have another option. I call it the Houdini effect. You know, the Houdini effect is, you know, Houdini made a living out of what? You know, finding a way where there was no way. That was really his tagline, right? He would get it. He would say, I'm going to be underwater, handcuffed in a straitjacket, you know, and then he'd find a way to get out of it. So that's that commitment level, you know. So when you make that decision, then tell yourself, hey, listen, whether it be the diet, whether it be the relationship, whether it be the business, whether it be the next move, whatever that is that you're going to say you're going to do, then ask yourself, can I do it at 98 to 100%? And then when you could say yes, I could put 98% to 100% in, then just like a horse out to races, boom, you go. And then you could course correct along the way and you learn. And then no matter what hits you, like that rocky poster right there, you know, you keep on stopping. So as you can see, like I have, remember, I create vision rooms. My house is created. So Rocky, you know, when you look at that movie, he had a decision to commit. And it was actually in Rocky 1. It was very subtle, but for the fans, you'll catch it. So Rocky 1, he was getting beat by Apollo, right? Because he was already underdog. He already was able to fight for the champion title. And he was getting beat. And around the last two rounds or three rounds, you know, he was very timid because he was fighting the champion. He was an underdog. And, you know, you could tell he was a little timid. He wasn't really going full hero. And then the round was in between, and he just got pissed. He got kind of pissed off. And then they wanted to stop the fight. He's like, no. And he said these words, and he said this word, the sentence. He goes, I'm not going down no more. And it's that I am. So he, in that moment, he declared, I am not going down no more. And of course, in the music, and he stands up, and he went up losing to Apollo, but he didn't go down anymore. And then that set the attitude, it set the tone over the next couple movies of him rising to the top to become the champion. And so the same thing. So when you make that decision and then you commit, then you go forward. And committing is very, very important. Because I remember when it even came to all the social media stuff, a lot of people like, what happened over the last 3 months? I never did social media at all. I thought it was the work of the devil, to tell you the truth. I thought it was very distracting. You know, I had all my dogmas. I had all my belief systems of what it was. But then I realized one day that, you know, I thought, look what happened to society, that we don't even communicate normal anymore. Like, we don't talk, you know, in person anymore. So I had all these old-time fashion belief systems to keep me comfortable or in a non-knowing aspect. Then I realized, well, wait a second. Social media allows us to talk to thousands of people in a short 15 minutes and allows us to really communicate and become more interactive with each other than ever before. So when I realized that, I woke up, all right? So I said, I'm gonna make a decision to start doing this. This is when the hero stuff started coming. I'm like, okay, so what do I need to do? And so you write down, this is the things I gotta do. Here's my goals, whatever that might be in the area of your life. It's usually gonna be in relationships, business, finances, or your purpose, or your health. And I'm like, wow, look at all the stuff I gotta do. So I'm gonna have to go on Facebook. I'm gonna have to go on Snapchat and Twitter and Instagram. I'm gonna have to do YouTube stuff. We're gonna have to shoot videos. Josh Axe, I don't know if you guys remember, probably it was in January, I did a Facebook Live with Josh Axe and Jordan Rubin, and I got 60,000 views in one day. And that day, I said, okay, I have to do Facebook Lives. And I go to Josh, Dr. Axe, and I go, well, how many do you do? How long do you do? He's like, I do them every day. And that's when they did them every day. I'm like, holy crap, every day? So I'm like, all right, it's got to be every day. So I got together what needed to be done, and then I had to make an honest assessment and say, Chris, are you going to commit to do this? And if you're going to commit to do it and say you're going to do it to yourself personally, not for everybody else, then you need to do it. And so, you know, I read a book. It was talking about, like, we need to become like apple trees now, well, or any type of tree. An apple tree is concerned with one thing. It makes apples, right? That's what it does. It doesn't care about anybody else's opinion. It doesn't care about the weather. Its job is to express itself and what it's created to do. So I'm like, all right, that's what we're going to do. So once I made the decision, I talked to Whitney, I got her approval. All that has to happen to say, boom, now we're committed. And then if you see my analytics, it's like years, and then all of a sudden it goes like this. My analytics are, because I just made the decision, boom. 15-minute fuel every single day. Then we started doing, you know, I hired Battleborn Media, and they started doing the videos and documenting, and we went all in because we were committed. Because anything less than that wouldn't be committed. So if I know I could do so, so now I'm thinking about podcasting. So even though you could go on SoundCloud and iTunes and all these other things and get this, or you might be listening to this right now because you're not watching the video, I realize that podcast and audio help people save more time because you don't have to watch me. So now I'm like, well, I need to up the podcast game and all these other things. So once you make a commitment, only go in if you know you could be 98 to 100% in. And what's the 2%? Because you're going to have good days and bad days. I get it. That's where you become a potentialist. But right there, once you make the commitment, I want you to understand, when you make a commitment, you seal everything behind you, you burn the bridges, you break the boats, and you don't give yourself the option to retreat. And then you just move forward and enjoy the journey of it. Enjoy the fear. Because If you don't put yourself in a position to get uncomfortable, you'll never grow. You'll never develop. So doing these 15-minute fuels, some of the things that that brought about a couple things was being very controlling, you know, in the end product, because I like to control the situation. I would have a couple really good 15-minute fuels, and you guys would just comment, and we'd get a bunch of likes, or we'd do a We Are a Hero show, and it was a hit. And I started feeling the stress and the anxiety of, how are we going to beat that last one? How am I going to better the last show? And we would do it. But after a while, then the pressure got stronger. How am I going to beat that one? How am I going to better it? And I realized that, you know, the stress of that meant that my happiness was determined and only dependent, and being loved was only dependent on the opinions of other people. Because I was trying to, how do I better it? How do I get more response? And then I realized, that's too stressful. So if I allow the stress to get to me, I either quit, but I'm committed. So I'm like, I'm going to surrender to the process, meaning that there'll be great shows, there'll be so-so shows, and there'll be, you know, great comments. And so, you know, just that's just what it is. But that's not going to define who I am as a character. You know, I'm not going to be like, oh, I had low views today, so now I'm a failure. Because that's what I did in chiropractic. I based my identity on my office, on being the doctor, not who I was as a human being. So if I saw a lot of people one week, I was a happy person, a great husband, and a wonderful father. But if my volume was down one week, then I was the grumpy guy, don't speak to me kind of husband. You see what I mean? So I let my profession dictate who I was. And because that was a habit, and that's kind of what I'd known, getting into this, you could see those old habits getting to play. So just become self-aware, be committed, and be okay. Don't be, be needless in the fact. Just go out and do the best you can with what you got in the moment you have. That's where the potentialist came from. The potentialist concept was very freeing in my life, knowing that today, all I could ask of myself and all you could ask of yourself is to do the best you can with what you got in the moment you have it. So always start off with being committed. So today, my exercise for you, because now we're going to actually apply this. You know, in the next 30 days, we're going to do it with you, and you're actually going to do something. So I need you to pick one thing. What's one thing in your life? One thing. Don't do 10. Just do one. Because you could do this program every month for one thing. So pick the one thing. This is going to be your one thing that if you knew you were more committed to, you would have better health, or it could be better finances, or it could be better relationships, or it could be a better business, better at work. So what's the one thing that you want to be more committed to? What's that one thing? Now, what I need you to do to stay accountable, I want you to, even if you're not watching this live, I want you to put it in the comments below. What's the one thing you knew that if you were committed to a little bit more, you would get much better results that would better you. So 1 month from now, if you were really committed to that one thing, eating better, exercising, going on date nights, showing up to work a little bit earlier, sleeping a little bit later, earlier, whatever that is, reading a book, listening to an audio, whatever that is, what is that one thing? Don't say exercise, you know, just be like, if I exercised, you know, 3 days a week, you know, whatever, be a little bit specific, and that's the only thing we're going to work on for this entire month, and we're going to put these principles according just to that one thing, so at the end of that month, you'll see how you're doing great in that area, and then, if you want, you do the program again with maybe two things, okay, so now, let's say it's going to be getting the eating down, you get the eating down for a month, it's habitual, you're winning there, and now you're like, okay, good, I'm going to add a little exercise in, and I'm going to start reading on the exercise bike, so you know, you gradually step it up. And then you start to build this habitual routine. And then you just start making massive wins every single day. So comment below or private message me on the things you want to work with. One thing that you're gonna be that you know that if you were committed to, you would have a better relationship, you'd have more finances, be better at work, and your health would be better, or it could be something that affects them all. But what's the one thing? And that's a thing that's gonna be your main thing that we're gonna be committed to and we're gonna win at. So in 1 month, if you could really win in one area, how much more effective would that be, and how much would you appreciate life and everything that's going on? So that's our goal. So number one thing is you got to be committed. Pick that thing. What are you going to be committed to? And solidify that. Put that in your refrigerator. Write that word out, whatever that idea would be, and we're going to go for it. And you're going to nail this thing. You're going to win it, and you're going to win big by the end of the month. So that's today's version of 15 Minute Fuel. Make sure you go to, iamhero.com to register to get the 1 month to win. So you can see the video, you can see the exercises, you can see the one page article that goes along with it. Also, We Are Heroes episode 40 is live. This is a great one. This is actually the one before that you saw. I went to Dr. Josh Axe. Him and I were hanging out. This one, we traveled home. So I have some great travel tips on there as well. Check that out, and just some good concepts. And then just, again, share that, like it, love it, just like this. Show the love, show the heart, show the hugs, and hit the share button. Have a great day. I will see you tomorrow with 15 Minute Fuel, where we're doing our 1 month to win series. We're just in 15 minutes a day. We'll be able to fuel your mind, your body, and your future. God bless.